Hello students, welcome to my channel tutelf.com. The topic that we are going to do today is scalar and vector quantities. So scalar and vector quantities are the two physical quantities, and these physical quantities, on the basis of the components, they are divided as a scalar quantity and a vector quantity. So now you can see on the screen that there is a car. Imagine that I say that you have to go 20 kilometer. So this car can go in any direction. That is, it can go towards right, it can go towards north, it can go towards like at the back, towards your left, and it can go down. So it can go in any direction. When I only specify the magnitude here is the distance that I have set. So when I specify only the magnitude, then the quantity is said to be a scalar quantity. And when I say that this car will go 20 kilometer west, so in that case I know that the car is going backwards, like towards my left, 20 kilometers. So we can say that a vector quantity has both a magnitude, that is 20 kilometer, and the direction, that is either the west direction, or I can say left, or I can say back. So whenever we have just the magnitude, that is a scalar quantity. And when I have both the magnitude as well as the direction associated with it, it's the vector quantity. Now there are various physical quantities which has only the magnitude, and there are many physical quantities which has both magnitude as well as direction associated with it. Now just have a look at this thermometer. So when I say that the temperature is 30 degrees Celsius, in that case, I am just telling you the magnitude. So when I just tell you the magnitude, it becomes a scalar quantity. But usually what I say is that there is a rise of 20 degrees Celsius. So when I say that there is a rise of 20 degrees Celsius, I am telling you the direction as well, as it could be the rise or the fall of the temperature, right? So in that case, the temperature, it becomes a vector quantity. Now let's see a few more cases. So distance is the total path that is covered. So it is given as 20 kilometers. That is a scalar quantity. But if I say that a car moves 20 kilometers south, that means that it has both a magnitude as well as direction associated with it. So it becomes a vector quantity. Now let us see another physical quantity. So we have mass. Now mass, I say that the body weighs 10 kg. So in that case, 10 kg is the mass of the object. But when I say that the weight of the object on a weighing machine is 10 kg, in that case, I am telling the force that is applied, that is mg, that is being displayed by the measurement machine. So in that case, since g is associated and g acts in the downward direction, we all know that. So in that case, the weight it gives us, because weight is mass into g, so weight gives us the vector quantity, and the mass, it gives us the scalar quantity. I hope it is clear to you. Why weight is a vector quantity is because the mass is applied in the downward direction. So when magnitude and direction both are there, it's a vector quantity. And when only the magnitude is there, it becomes a scalar quantity. Now let's have a look at force. So force equals mass times acceleration. So acceleration has direction associated with it. Since it's a vector quantity, so our force, it is a vector quantity. I hope this is clear to you. Let's quickly summarize what we have just learned. So physical quantities are of two type. One is a scalar quantity and the other is a vector quantity. The scalar quantities are those physical quantities which has only magnitude associated with it. And in the vector, we have both a magnitude as well as a direction associated with it. So magnitude, for example, is 20 meter, and magnitude along with direction is 20 meter northeast. So this direction could be a specific direction, or when you say left, right, or when you say forward, backward. So it could be any sort of direction. I hope this is clear to you. Please stay tuned to tutelf.com for more educational videos related to science and mathematics for grade 1 to 12. I hope the concept is clear to you. If you have any doubt, please do not forget to write it in the comment section. Do visit our website www.tutelf.com for more educational content and for the test papers as well. Those are in form of a very fun activity quiz, and you will be graded instantly. Thank you. So our next video is going to be related to this only. So till then, take care. Bye.